I have just received this Lenovo IdeaPad 515. It's equipped with an AMD Ryzen 4800U processor, 16GB of memory, and a 70Wh battery. Now, many, such as myself, have been wondering how well this system can handle Linux distributions, and more in general, how well AMD Renoir processors are already supported on various Linux distributions. Now, I intend on testing this further and more in depth in future videos, but as you can see, just for testing, I've tried to install Manjaro Linux on the system and it worked basically flawlessly. I just created a regular USB installer. As you can see, I've used the XFCE desktop environment, booted from it with the regular stock out-of-the-box BIOS or UEFI settings, and created a new partition, FAT32, with the boot EFI section on it, and the rest of my half a terabyte SSD was used for, as you can see, Manjaro Linux. Now, out of the box, pretty much everything I've tested up to this point works. As you can see, my Wi-Fi card was found and is being and can be used perfectly and without any issue. And what's especially surprising is that out of the box, the touchscreen works as well. Now, what's most interesting, of course, is the support of the Vega GPU in our AMD Renoir processor. And as you can see, using a Unigen Heaven benchmark, I can just start this. If you take them, it should only take a few seconds. It works perfectly on this AMD Renoir APU. Now you may hear the fans ramping up. That's of course to be expected when running a benchmark like this. But as you can see, we're getting 47, 46, something around that now, 60 frames per second. Everything is working perfectly. Everything is accelerated out of the box. Now I have upgraded the kernel from 5.6 something, which was what I got out of the box when installing Manjaro, to 5.7. But other than that, I did nothing to the system and everything, as you can see, works as expected. Up to this point, I have not tested things like standby or hibernate, but something I have tested along with networking is, if you give me a second, I just need to plug in the HDMI cable, support for multiple monitors via HDMI. Now, as you can see, I just need to make a small adjustment because for some reason when plugging in an HDMI cable, I get basically this somewhat mirroring of the desktop. But if I just do this, now, as you can see, or let's just put this on the top, I have two independently working monitors, and I can put this down here and get it up here again, and everything works as expected. Again, this is actually a really, really good base for running Linux distributions on a notebook, seeing how stuff like the touchscreen, the Wi-Fi chipset, the APU, everything seems to work as intended. I have at the moment not done further testing on stuff like USB-C support, how the battery life is, whether I can get a fingerprint reader to work, or maybe whether it already somehow works out of the box. Things like that I'm going to test more in depth in a future video, so look forward to that. I also intend on doing some extensive testing both for productivity and more leisurely gaming task benchmarks like that in a future video, both on Windows and on Linux distributions. I'm also going to look into support of Ubuntu distributions out of the box and what may need to be modified to get those working perfectly. And I also intend to, of course, look into how well this device is built, upgradability, noise vibrations, harshness, all these things, pretty much simply to go as in-depth as possible and to inform you about the shortcomings and advantages that the Lenovo IdeaPad 515 equipped with an AMD Ryzen 4800U in this configuration at this price has. But for someone like myself who intends on running mainly Linux distributions on the system, this is already a very, very great basis, a very great starting point for everything to work. Lastly, I intend on looking very much in depth on whether and how well I can get virtualization of multiple systems, Linux distributions and containers, stuff like that, to work on this system, as that's something I'm very much interested in. So if you are interested in all these things, if you want to hear more about this, I recommend you might follow my channel or subscribe and look forward to these videos. So, thank you very much for your attention. But as you can see, on an AMD RenRAR system, we already have a very, very great basis for running Linux distributions.